हमारे अगले वक्ता मूलतः विज्ञान के विद्वान हैं, डॉक्टर पीके सिसोदिया जी, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स विभाग के एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर हैं और ये जापान में एज अ विजिटिंग साइंटिस्ट काम कर चुके हैं। मैं उनसे अनुरोध करूंगी कि वे आएँ, डॉक्टर पीके सिसोदिया।
जापान के संबंधों के बारे में कि हमारा जो इकोनॉमिक आर्थिक और जो संबंध रहा है, हालांकि इतिहास पे पहले सत्र में शायद काफ़ी डिबेट हुआ है और उन्होंने एक बैकग्राउंड दिया है कि किस तरह से जापान के साथ हमारा आर्थिक सहयोग रहा है। इन 1991 दैट वाज द क्रूशियल पॉइंट फॉर द इंडिया एंड द टेस्ट ऑफ द रिलायबिलिटी ऑफ द जापान एज ए फ्रेंड इन 1991 विच बेल आउट अवर ड्यूरिंग दैट बैलेंस ऑफ पेमेंट क्राइसिस। रिलेटेड टू दैट वन मीन्स एज फार एज वी ऑल नो के मारुति के आने से जो हमारा चेंज हुआ है, जापान की होंडा, टोयोटा, सोनी, डिफरेंट कंपनीज यहाँ पे अपने प्लांट्स लगा रही हैं और उस तरह से हमारा जो इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलपमेंट में रोज़गार जो पैदा हो रहे हैं उसमें काफ़ी हमें फ़ायदा हुआ है। और ये सब चीज़ें सिर्फ हमारी जो पॉलिटिकल विंग है उन्होंने इसको शुरू किया था और मनमोहन सिंह जी का जो सहयोग जो इसमें सहयोग रहा है कि 2006 में एक्चुअली साइंटिफिक कोलैबोरेशन में 1998 पोखरण में जो पोखरण ब्लास्ट वो टेस्ट हुए थे तो सब ऑलमोस्ट ऑल कंट्रीज बैंड ऑल अवर साइंटिफिक कोलैबोरेशंस एंड ऑल दैट। सो ओनली दैट पीरियड जापान हैज़ नॉट कोलैबोरेटेड विद अस, बट आफ्टर दैट इन 2000 ऑनवर्ड्स द थिंग्स हैज चेंज्ड एंड अ लॉट ऑफ cooperation in finance, in infrastructure development and all that is going on. Japan, the third largest economy hai, as far as that the GDP is concerned and the fourth largest purchasing power in the world. Jo mera ek saal mein wahan pe as a visiting scientist raha 2003 se 2004 mein aur uske baad bhi maine do baar maine visit kiya hai Nagoya University and the different universities I have visited. बेसिकली इफ़ यू सी द वर्किंग स्टाइल, हम लोगों का यहाँ पे भी लैब है, रिसर्च वर्क अब हम लोग यहाँ पे भी कर रहे हैं, बट इफ़ यू सी एट 2003 के संदर्भ में यदि हम आज देखें तो काफ़ी हम लोगों ने प्रोग्रेस की है, तरक्की की है, लेकिन उस टाइम ऐसा लगता था कि जैसे दिल्ली यूनिवर्सिटी में, क्योंकि मैंने अपना PhD का कार्य भी यहीं पर किया था, लगता था कि जैसे कोई फैसिलिटी नहीं है, है भी तो बहुत लिमिटेड है, जितने काम करने वाले हैं उनके हिसाब से बहुत ही उसमें कम वो है। लेकिन वहाँ पे जाके इफ़ यू सी एनी लैब्स, जो वहाँ का वर्किंग कल्चर है, मतलब दे डोंट सी एनी टाइमिंग बाउंडेशंस, दे इफ़ दे हैव टू वर्क दे विल वर्क डे एंड नाइट, कोई उनके ऊपर पाबंदी नहीं है, स्टूडेंट्स आर फ्री टू कम टू द लैब्स एंड ऑल दैट। जो फैसिलिटीज़ हैं यहाँ पे, यदि आप काम करने लगें तो आपको डिपेंडेंट रहना है बहुत सारे पैरामीटर्स पे। मेन प्रॉब्लम इज़ द लैंग्वेज, लैंग्वेज बैरियर बहुत ज़्यादा है। यदि आप साइंटिफिक उसमें जाएं तो वहाँ पे भी जो साइंटिस्ट हैं ओनली फ्यू प्रोफेसर्स आर इंग्लिश स्पीकिंग, आप हिंदी में उनसे बात नहीं कर सकते हैं, बहुत कम लोग हैं जो हिंदी या ना ट्रेंड हैड चेंज एंड द पीपल आर लर्निंग इंग्लिश, अर्लियर दे वर कन्फाइंड ओनली टू दैट योर दिस जैपनीज। The official development assistance, what the Japan has given to us or how that you are that this is involved with that. So till March 13 means we are be having that 3807.7 billion yen contributed up to this data is up to that 2013 with that, and the 66 projects are under implementation for that the Japanese loan assistance means. How much the Japan is investing in India to build up our infrastructure, whether metro rail is one of them, then we can see a different, you may be aware or not, the Japan has all also helping us to make this dedicated freight corridor from Delhi to Calcutta, Delhi to Bombay. Dedicated freight corridors is being under constructions and this will take of course that you the time to come up in the next 15-20 years or but the projection is very high. One is that you are the this Delhi Mumbai industrial corridor, Nowadays, our Modi ji, the Prime Minister, says that we will develop some cities, high-tech cities across that one. So that high-tech cities are going to come across this corridors. Whether it's that you're the Delhi-Mumbai industrial corridor, within that the sites have been identified. The state governments are doing their job to get that you're the lands and acquiring lands and all that. So that process is in all. So this is to be implemented to be there. Then apart from that means we also have in a Japan-India Business Leaders Forum is there just to look after that, that the Chamber of Commerce and all that parameters. Though I am not related to that, you're the more of that to the economic side, but these are the few points on which that you're the Japan is assisting India to build infrastructure in all that you're the development projects. We have now ores, we have a minerals and all that. Technologies with them, with the, Japan. So we export ores, minerals to them, and the final products come out to be from there, which we are working in that tandem over there. In the direction of science and technology, basically, if we see, it is long back to that you are the 1956. 1956 or 1957. That this cultural agreement for that the science and technology cooperation is going on. And now that we are having that you're the between the two countries, November 85 implemented through India-Japan Joint Committee. There is a one India-Japan Joint Committee which is implementing this science and technology developments in India. We are also with that means in 1998 the nuclear test and we faced some problems during that, but later on in 2000 Indo-Japan Science Congress was formulated and the area of cooperations was raised to the total areas to six. In that six again that you're the visits of our, but the one important point over here is that our prime ministers, the visits of that you're the prime minister of both the countries has continued. I'm not going year-wise on that, but in 2005, Japanese PM Koizumi visit India, or in 2006, the PM Manmohan Singh visits Japan. So that summit is going on every year. There is a the council meeting, what we used to have, that is every year the council meeting has either in Japan or either in India to carry on this much. So as far as that you're the Japan's priority strategies for science technology is concerned, it's the promotion of that you're the basic research. And they are trying to invest very heavily. And Department of Science and Technology, and there is that you're the Japan Society for Promotion of Research. These are the two coordinating the nodal agencies, which coordinates the programs for that you're the science funding. There may be many more for that you're the other subjects also. I'm not very much aware with all that because being in that you're the science, I can only talk, means aware with that you're the, this science programs which is underway and the collaborations in which that you're the Japan is helping over there. The priorities area of the Japan was as you say nowadays, nanotechnology, materials, energy, manufacturing sciences, infrastructure and the frontier science. And for that, this is implemented through that you're the India-Japan Joint Committee on Cooperation in Science and Technology. So this is a basic involvement of that you're the two governments through Department Science of Technology and that you're the Joint Committee Science and Technology counterpart in that you're the Japan Society for Promotion of Research. So they are taking care of all these parameters. They are involved with then astronomy, astrophysics, surface science, nuclear science, or space science. And every year, as I say right now, India-Japan Science Council meetings is held, and the decisions are taken, and how to promote, and what are that the outcomes related to that parameters. This is again new initiatives has also been carried out through this the renewed visit of our Prime Minister and that you are the Prime Minister of Japan, Abe, between Minister in charge of science and technology at the two countries. institutional cooperation. Let me just say in which the major cooperation is going on at present. If we see Japan Science and Technology Agency, JST, and the Department of Science and Technology of India are collaborating on that, you're the Indian High Beam Line Facility and High Energy Accelerator Research Organization in Subuka. Subuka station and accelerator center have been fabricated and dedicated 4 to 5 Indian scientists are stationed over there, and the limited time, means 360 hours, have been allocated to Indian researchers over there. And that is being maintained by that you are the our Indian scientists over there in Subuka. Subuka basically is nearby town of Tokyo, which is known as a science city, where you have so many universities, some research labs, very fine research labs, where this JAXA, Japan Space Exploration Research Agencies and all that. So they in correlation with that, National Institute of Advanced Studies, Department of Biotechnology, Japan ke jo NSAIST hai, AIST means the National Institute, they are working in with that yoda in the biotechnology in India. Similarly, many more means Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, if I think you may be aware with that, CSIR, is also involved in one of that you are the parameter. Then you also have a Jawaharlal Nehru Center for Advanced Scientific Research. This is, they are also working in that, you're the AIST. Indian Institute of Science is also involved in one of that, you're the one-to-one program over there in Raikin. And as I say, ISRO and JAXA, the space science, they are coordinating the joint research programs over there, as far as that you're the, and because of that means Indian scientists and that you're the Japanese scientists, they work together, few things carried out over here in India, and then we go over there or they come visit to us. So there is a bilateral programs between India and Japan, in which that you're the scientist as well as that you're the PhD students visit each other labs and coordinate the work. There have been so many MOUs have been signed, I'm not going into that one. In cooperation in nuclear science technology is also going on after that you're the Pokhran test, and as well as that you're the defense cooperation is also there. Nowadays Malabar, some Navy trials with a joint exercise with that you're the America, Australia and Japan, that has been planned, and in last years also there had been carried out these activities. So this sort of the relationship exists between that you are the two countries. Many more means this is on that you are the science perspective. I have just talked about you. With these words, I thank you once again.
Science or technology ke kshetr mein Bharat Japan sambandhon par prakash dalne ke liye dhanyawad. Hamare agle vakta rajnitik विज्ञान से हैं प्रोफेसर बदरुल आलम जी. इन्होंने लगभग 2 दशक से भारत के साथ साथ यूनाइटेड स्टेट तथा जापान में अध्यापन का कार्य किया है. प्रोफेसर बदरुल आलम जी.
थैंक यू फैकल्टी मेंबर्स डॉक्टर बी आर अम्बेडकर कॉलेज एंड ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स. ए टॉपिक जो है भारत जापान, एक्चुअली दिस इज ए ग्रेट इंटरेस्ट टू मी पर्सनली. 1998 जनवरी से लेके 2006 जनवरी 8 साल आई वॉज ए फुल प्रोफेसर ऑफ पॉलिटिकल साइंस एंड इंटरनेशनल रिलेशंस इन जापान. यू नो जापान वॉज हैड अंडरगॉन लॉट ऑफ दिस कल्चरल वेरिएशंस ओवर द लास्ट मेनी मेनी सेंचुरीज. फ्रॉम 13th सेंचुरी टू रफली 19th सेंचुरी, फॉर मोर देन 500 ईयर्स जापान वेंट थ्रू ए स्टेज ऑफ आइसोलेशन. That is the Edo period or Tokugawa period. Okay, so Japan was basically cut off from the rest of the world. That's the time when Japanese have got these hierarchy systems, the shogun, the daimyo at the top, the samurai and other classes. Then came the Meiji period, then the post-Meiji period, then the war, then the post-war and the rest of it. I think there are a lot of things in Japan I really like. I think most of you probably heard from Urmila Sahab ki Japan ek monocultural society unlike India, which is very pluralistic. In India, every 100 miles you travel, people talk differently, look differently, act differently, eat differently, har cheez alag hai. Japan aisa nahi hai. 4 islands jo hain main, Hokkaido islands, Honshu island, Shikoku islands aur Kyushu islands, आप पूरा सापोरो, टोक्यो, ओसाका, सिमाने, नागोया, नागानो, ओकायामा, फुकुओका, नागासाकी, पूरा चले आइए. एवरीबॉडी स्पीक्स जापानीज लैंग्वेज, दे ऑल लुक अलाइक्स. एंड इफ यू गो टू ओकिनावा, व्हिच इज जस्ट लाइक आवर अंडमान निकोबार, पीपल लुक लिटिल बिट डिफरेंट एंड हैव अ लिटिल बिट डिफरेंट वेरिएशंस, बट बेसिकली इट इज अ वन पर्टिकुलर सोसाइटी. अनदर थिंग इन जापान, जापान इज अ वेरी मच इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय चाइनीज कल्चर एंड ऑल्सो दे बिलीव इन कल्चरल होमोजेनिटी और कल्चरल कन्फर्मिटी. Okay, they don't like to argue on any particular thing. I think this is embedded in their particular culture. Maybe this is a part of the culture they inherited from Confucius. तो जैसे एक होती है उनकी मेन रिलीजन होते हैं बुद्धिज्म एंड सिंटोइज्म. सिंटोइज्म के एक मेन बेस है हारमोनी विथ नेचर. तो हर चीज़ उनका हारमोनियस वे में है. तो मुझे दिक्कत ये होती थी कि मैं JNU से सीधा अमेरिका गया, वहाँ 15 साल रहा, वहाँ पढ़ाई किया और वहाँ पढ़ाया भी बच्चों को, साहब जो प्रोफेसर इन न्यूयॉर्क एंड केंटकी. तो अमेरिकन एजुकेशन सिस्टम इज मोर लाइक ए अम्बेडकर कॉलेज सिस्टम और JNU सिस्टम. वी बिलीव इन एक्टिव टॉकिंग, वी बिलीव इन क्रिटिकल थिंकिंग, ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ थिंग्स. जापान इज ऑलमोस्ट लाइक गिव गिव गिव, टेक टेक टेक, ए बड़े हारमोनियस काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स. एंड क्रिटिकल थिंकिंग डेवलप करना स्टूडेंट्स में, इट्स ए रियली ए वेरी वेरी बिग चैलेंज. स्टूडेंट्स विल बी वेरी हेजिटेंट एंड वेरी रिलक्टेंट टू से एनीथिंग विच इज नॉट पॉलिटिकली करेक्ट और विच मे नॉट बी ट्रू आफ्टर ऑल. सो यहाँ के स्टूडेंट जो हैं, अमेरिकन स्टूडेंट अगर बोलोगे 2+6 कितना, अरे 2+6 20. सो आप बोलेंगे 2+6 8, कौन सी बड़ी बात है, 20 और 8, बस 12 की फ़र्क है. सो बट यू नो जापान, दे विल थिंक 100 times वट एवर दे आर राइटिंग ऑन द बोर्ड और थिंग्स लाइक दैट, इट इज करेक्ट काइंड ऑफ थिंग. सो आई थिंक कल्चरल होमोजिनिटी इज़ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. एंड अनदर थिंग आई थिंक हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड द हिस्ट्री ऑफ जापान, पर्टिकुलरली आफ्टर द वार. When Japan lost the war and the Emperor Hirohito, he signed the surrender ceremony, okay? And then the constitution was framed under the command of the American commander Douglas MacArthur. Ek America ka constitution banaya gaya. And the first prime minister of Japan in the post-war, Shigeru Yoshida, there is a doctrine called Yoshida Doctrine. So he wanted to make Japan, quote-unquote, a normal country. What is a normal country? Normal country matlab kya? India is a normal country, okay? Normal country mein army hote hain, नेवी होते हैं, लड़ाई होती है, जीतते हैं, हारते हैं, चलता रहता है, ओके. जापान डज नॉट हैव एनी आर्मी, डजंट हैव एनी एयरफोर्स, डजंट हैव एनी नेवी, डजंट हैव एनी डिफेंस डिपार्टमेंट. दे हैव SDF, सेल्फ डिफेंस फोर्स, बिकॉज देर इज अ लॉट ऑफ नेचुरल कलामिटीज दैट टेक प्लेस इन जापान, लाइक टाइफून, लाइक अर्थक्वेक, लाइक वोल्केनो एटसेट्रा. सो आर्टिकल 9 ऑफ द जापानीज कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. SDF, दैट्स वाई यू मस्ट हैव सीन इन द इराक वार, इन अफगानिस्तान वार, इन मेनी मेनी वार, कोसोवो एटसेट्रा. जापान वॉज नॉट ए पार्टिसिपेंट एक्टिवली इन द वार लाइक सिचुएशन, बट इन ए पोस्ट वार रिकवरी सिचुएशन जापान कंट्रीब्यूटेड इन टर्म्स ऑफ फाइनेंशियल एड, इन टर्म्स ऑफ मेनी डिफरेंट थिंग्स. जापान इज ऑल्सो वेरी एक्टिव इन आसियान, इन सार्क. आई डोंट लाइक टू गो इन टू डिटेल्स. हमारे इंडिया और जापान से काफ़ी पुरानी रिश्ता है, गोइंग बैक ऑल द वे टू 6th century व्हेन द बुद्धिस्ट कनेक्शन. अनदर कनेक्शन वॉज ए पर्सन कॉल्ड रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर, ओके. एंड ही गॉट द रिसीव द नोबेल प्राइज फॉर लिटरेचर 1 year बिफोर वर्ल्ड वॉर वन इन 1913. एंड ही वॉज द फर्स्ट एशियन टू बी द रिसिपियंट ऑफ नोबेल प्राइज इन लिटरेचर. हिज वर्क गीतांजलि एंड ऑल ऑफ हिज वर्क हैज बीन ट्रांसलेटेड इन जापानीज एंड इट इज लिटरली एवरी स्टूडेंट इन जापान दे नो अबाउट टैगोर्स राइटिंग्स. दैट इज वन ऑफ द फेमस जापानीज नॉवलिस्ट कॉल्ड तेनसिन ओकाकुरा. ही वॉज हाईली इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय रविन्द्रनाथ टैगोर. Another person in the post-war situation, there was a Tokyo War Tribunal. All the judges they favored in favor of death penalty and hanging of the Japanese war criminal, the Japanese Red Army people. There is one judge in the Tokyo War Tribunal happened to be a person from India, Justice Radha Binod Pal. He gave a dissenting judgment. Many people in Japan they still remember that. Japan was also, like India, a founding member of the UN Charter in San Francisco. One of the pivotal moments came in 1949 when then Prime Minister of India, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, visited Tokyo. He went to the Tokyo Ueno Zoo and he presented a baby elephant. And people loved that because the elephant was named after Nehru's daughter Indira. So that Indira became an iconic figure in Japan for many, many years. Japan and India, they entered into diplomatic relations in 1952. जस्ट 3 years ago in 2012, Japan and India, they completed 6 decades, 60 years of diplomatic relations. Then you have got series of prime ministers between India and Japan. मैं एक चीज़ पर कंसंट्रेट करूँगा, इंडियाज वायबिलिटी नॉट ओनली एज अ हार्ड पावर बट ऑल्सो एज अ सॉफ्ट पावर एंड ए स्मार्ट पावर. इंडिया की जहाँ तक सॉफ्ट पावर की सवाल है, एज यू ऑल नो इंडिया की सॉफ्ट पावर वहाँ काफ़ी पॉपुलर्स है. जब मैं 8 साल वहाँ था प्रोफेसर, काफ़ी कोर्स भी पढ़ा है, जापान इंडिया रिलेशंस, कल्चर्स ऑफ इंडिया. ओके, तो बॉलीवुड पिक्चर्स आर वाइडली पॉपुलर एंड जापानीज पीपल दे लव इट. इंडियाज पब्लिक डिप्लोमेसी in terms of different chairs, different educational programs in Tokyo, Waseda and many places, India's music, India's literature, India's democratic traditions, open society, Indian concept of non-alignment, Indian cuisine, Indian textiles, Indian exports, Indian media, Indian education sector, Indian diaspora, which is not a very big number, but they're also making a sizable impact on there. India's elite, Mohandas K. Gandhi, India's ancient thinker like Kautilya, which is very well known, Tagore, as I told you, India's splendid diversity, multiculturalism, unity in diversity. Japan, as I told you before, is a monocultural, unicultural society, but they take a lot of pride in the fact that India has survived as one country in spite of the fact that India is a land of unity in diversity. And also the things like Ayurveda, yoga, Indian spirituality, they are also extremely popular. Time जब मैं bullet train पे गया Tokyo से Osaka, so suddenly आप देखोगे पूरा numbering जो mileage 200, 300, 350, 400 काफ़ी speed में चल रही है. You can never feel that you are traveling in a fast train which is traveling by 450, 500 kilometers per hour. So thank God now Japanese government is also helping us to have the first bullet train between Mumbai and Ahmedabad, and it will be operational probably by next year or something. Japan ka ek acha pehlu ye hai, usually when the Americans give some financial aid, they make a big halla hulla. Japanese people are very quiet, they do things quietly, but they do things very effectively and precisely. For example, Japanese ODA, Official Development Assistance, ये 3-4 चीज़ पर कंसंट्रेट करते हैं, फोकस करते हैं और सही ढंग से करते हैं. Entire underground metro system दिल्ली के जो हैं, phase 1, phase 2, phase 3 जो चल रहा है, total money has been given by Japan, okay, as a soft loan. अगर 99 years में दिए तो ठीक है, नहीं दिए तो चलेगा. So nobody will do that. Entire Ganges River cleaning project, Japan does it. Entire polio eradication drive in Bengal and many places in India, Japan does it. Forestation drive in Kanakapura, in Karnataka and many other places. Abhi Prime Minister Narendra Damodar Das Modi jab last year gaye the Kyoto, he declared Kyoto to be a this thing, heritage city, and he tried to link Kyoto with Varanasi. And Kyoto and Varanasi, they have become sister cities like a smart city program, and also under part of the Make in India program. So there are a lot of things are happening in the economic arena. I don't have to go into detail. Of course, Maruti Suzuki is one success story. There are many more success stories that I think it needs to be remember. So I think in terms of the IT software, I think somebody said that हमारी काफ़ी उसमें majority है, काफ़ी led है. India is considered to be IT superpower in software, and Japan is considered to be number one in hardware. No wonder in 2000 जब Yoshihiro Mori Prime Minister थे, usually Prime Minister जब India आते हैं पहले दिल्ली में they land, but he landed in Bangalore. Why? Because Bangalore is the Silicon Valley, the high tech capital, all the TCS, Wipro, Infosys, everything is based in Bangalore. So since then, Yoshihiro Mori, Junichiro Koizumi, then you have got Naoto Kan, and you know all other prime ministers, Shinzo Abe 1, and currently again Shinzo Abe 2, okay? So I think all of them, they're putting a lot of eggs in the IT basket, and I think it is a win-win proposition for both of them. So, but I think Japan is a beautiful place, lovely place, no pollution, and the longevity rate of Japanese people are the highest in the world, the literacy rate is the highest in the world, okay? But the problem is the language, and also another thing, it's a very expensive place. Thank you so much. Thank you.